Ancillary Sales Podcast. I'm your host, Michael Berg, and joined as always by Viv Hudson. And Viv, we got a special guest that we've had on before.
Yes, we have. One of my favorite people in the country. So can I do the introductions?
Absolutely.
Okay, so please welcome. We have Justin Roybal. He is allergy specialist extraordinaire. He has been in this space for a number of years. So what he doesn't know about allergy, nobody knows. So welcome, Justin.
Thank you, guys. I appreciate you having me today. Discuss a little bit of some updates with the allergy programs and just the customizable options that we're now seeing.
So allergy is it's been around. It was our first ancillary that was our real flagship ancillary program. Then, and the reason that it's popular is because it generates so much money for the practice. Allergy and immunotherapy is what we're talking about. Immunotherapy has a great reimbursement if they're doing the mixing of the immunotherapy in the practice. And we've experimented with some different programs that all attempt to capture this billing. The problem has been in the past with certain programs that because we may have provided a technician, whenever you provide the labor, then you have to adhere to certain minimums. And if you have a mid-range or smaller practice, what we found is that in the beginning they can get the patients, but you get diminishing returns over time. And then that puts a lot of pressure on the practice because they have to hit those patient minimums. And so we've experimented with some different programs. We have a couple programs going on right now that are pretty phenomenal that really address this issue. So Justin, first and foremost, could you give us a breakdown as to the top allergy programs right now that you're promoting?
Yeah, there are actually a couple that we are currently operating with. And the reason why I like them is that there shouldn't be a reason why we're not able to fit in either a smaller practice, maybe a physician's office that only has the one physician, maybe a nurse practitioner or a nurse. And then also we can customize a program to work with a bigger office that's maybe seeing, you know, quite a bit more patients in a week and on a daily basis. The great thing about it is both of them seem to be able to work and are conducive to different structures, different specialities. And it's really just started to pick up a little bit of traction. We've seen the numbers, you know, are speaking for themselves currently of what they're seeing out there, you know, with seven out of 10 Americans right now testing positive for more than one or two allergens. And in the past, what doctors felt comfortable with doing was simply either just prescribing them over-the-counter medications and kind of masking the symptoms, or in some cases, they were just sending them down the street to an allergist. And I've even heard of doctors maybe doing some testing in the office, and if they're seeing the patient come back, you know, with five or seven allergens, then they're going ahead and then sending them down the street to the allergist. So all in all, for most part, there's starting to be a bigger transition for those doctors to kind of help the patients alleviate their issues in-house with, you know, a sense of comfortability. They've already know the staff members and such. So what's great about the programs that we have is the numbers are not going to be quite an issue because there's two different ways to go about it. There are qualifications that need to be met. A little bit more stringent if you're looking at actually having our affiliates provide the technician, but if you're willing to train one of your staff members and maybe two staff members, because we all know someone might call in sick or they want to take a few days off for vacation, and you don't want to lose that traction that you've built with capturing patients' issues. So the great thing about it is that we can get them qualified if they're seeing a certain amount of number of patients a week or on a daily basis, and that, you know, that can be a good fit for practices that are super busy. The patients are coming in from a longer distance and they much rather just continue to see that doctor and not have to drive across town to see a specialist. So in a lot of cases, we can really just take the demographics of a practice and kind of fit them with which program would be the best fit for them.
So when you talk about the demographics, what are you looking at the payer mix or the patient age, or what kind of insurances are covering this?
Yeah, so those are, you know, great points to look at. In a lot of cases, you know, if we're seeing 10 to 15 patients a day because we are just an independent practice with one provider, age is not really becoming too much of an issue unless we get into the older mix of individuals, because Medicare is one that may pay for the test, but they're not too keen to actually paying for the treatment option because they kind of look at it as allergy's been around for quite a long time. I mean, I think, you know, upwards of 130 years, and they're saying, why would someone at, you know, age 72 now be looking at getting treatment for allergies when this is probably something they could have been alleviated from earlier on? So they tend to kind of shy away from wanting to take care of the Medicare patients. But there are some options for some pretty inexpensive cash pay options with one of our affiliates. So commercial is really that is really the group that we're going for, because that really should never be declined from a commercial payer, depending on what type of insurance plan they have. It's just going to be dependent on how many units they're willing to reimburse for. And where it can really start to get tricky is we like to also work with the on-site biller or the third-party biller as well, just to make sure that they are billing for that correctly, because it can come down to decimal points. Some insurance companies can be even a little bit tougher when it comes to it, and they'll may even say, you know, bill me for 120 units in the first week, and at the third week of the month, you know, bill me for the remainder of the program. So commercial is definitely a great fit for this program. Self-pay might be a good fit as well, depending on what type of practice. If it's more of a concierge practice where maybe they're paying a yearly fee to have that doctor at their disposal, or maybe a monthly fee, usually that doctor's working out something with them on some of the bigger treatment options where there's some financing available for them to get treatment. Or maybe the doctor will say, you know, come up with this much as a down payment for the program and you can pay me monthly payments for the remainder. So there are a different number of ways to go, but we are trying to stay away from Medicare and Medicaid.
So Justin, what has changed with this program compared to previous programs that we've promoted?
You know, Mike, probably the biggest change that we're currently seeing in the allergy space is the fact of companies trying to get away from the actual old-fashioned skin testing that may be done on the forearms or the back. Mm-hmm. Let's be honest, it can't be that much fun to have a ton of antigens, you know, sent on the skin to kind of see it flame up and see the wheels that have been brought on by the allergic reaction. And they're moving towards more of a finger prick test, which I feel is a great opportunity, not only for individuals that might be a little bit hesitant about getting skin tested, but honestly, it would work great for children as well, who may not want to sit there and be administered all those allergens to their skin. And the parents probably see it as a better option as well. And how it works is basically it's just a finger prick. There's going to be four little circles about quarter size on the lab card. And they would take the blotch blood and put it on those four spots and then put it into a laboratory sealed envelope and send it off to the lab. The great thing I like about this is not only is it region specific to the kinds of molds and grasses and such that are growing environmentally in that surrounding area, but it allows them to do a lot more invasive intrigue into the blood work with also food allergies. So tend to see about 35 to upwards of maybe 50 before the insurance company is not really wanting to reimburse for the old school scratch testing, where with this program, we're looking at somewhere between anywhere from 120 to 140, where you'll see 60 to 70 environmental allergens tested for, and also maybe 60 to 40, about 60 to 40 food allergies as well. So you're seeing a lot more detailed allergy testing when it comes to the blood option. So that that's something that we're starting to see a lot of progression with. And in some cases, you know, people do want to rely on the old skin testing. And once in a while, our affiliates are willing to accommodate them on doing the old treatment as well.
So if you have a doctor that is interested in the program, what are the steps to get the doctor onboarded?
Yeah, I mean, if the individual has done a great job of explaining the program and the doctor's looking to move forward right away, there is a qualifying form that we have from our affiliates that kind of just gives the clinic's demographics, their payer mix, their patient load, what their specialty is, what they're currently doing for those that are bringing up issues with, you know, allergies. If they need me to jump on a call with the doctor, I'm always free to do that for them. I can walk the doctor through. If they are coming with some pretty heavy invasive questions that maybe I'm just not comfortable with answering, I have no issue with getting, you know, one of our experts from our affiliate company on a call, and they're always willing to jump on a call with the doctor as well. We also like to suggest getting them the contract just so they can look at it, see if there's anything that, you know, they have issue with or questions they may have about it. And in some cases, when you're dealing with a bigger practice, they actually may have a legal team that wants to take a look at that as well.
So, Justin, last question. Let's talk turkey. What does this look like financially for the doctor, and what's changed in this model versus previous models that we promoted?
Yeah, and a lot of times what you'll see is there might be a flat rate fee for the actual administration of the allergy treatment. Make no means about it. Mixing that in-house is where you're going to see the revenue substantially grow for the clinic. What we're currently doing right now is what we would have is like a 60-40 split, where in a lot of other cases and in the past, you would see that 60% going to the actual allergy firm that might be offering the program to the doctor, and the doctor keeping 40%. In this case, we are now at a point where we're able to do a 40% to the allergy company, and that's basically just to cover the cost of goods, the allergy treatment, the allergens, the serums, the testing kits that would be used for the finger prick, and the doctor's actually keeping 60% of that reimbursement on that patient's insurance claim. So I'm very, very comfortable in saying that a doctor on average should see anywhere between $2,000 and $2,500 per patient that they actually move into the treatment option of the program.
And paying out 40% of that back to the allergy company is what you're saying. So they might net $1,200 to $1,500. Does that sound realistic?
I would say it's going to probably be a little bit more than that, Mike. I'm saying on average around $2,000 to $2,500 after they've paid their 40% back.
Oh, okay. My bad. Even better. Well, Justin, you've got a wealth of information.
Thanks, Justin.